Hello, leaders of the world. Today, we celebrate a significant milestone for SpreadLove In Organizations podcast. It has been an incredible journey filled with profound insights, heartfelt stories, and impactful chats. Over the past 2 years, we have had the honor of hosting 100 exceptional leaders, each with their unique experiences and perspectives. Through their stories, we have shared in their triumphs, challenges, and the invaluable lessons they have learned along the way. Our guests have touched our hearts, made us smile, reflect, and most importantly, prompted us to rethink our preconceptions about culture in high-performing organizations. To celebrate the 100th episode, we have compiled a special segment featuring the reactions of some of our influential guests to a question that has become synonymous with our podcast. What is your first reaction to Spread Love In Organizations? These diverse and thought-provoking responses represent the culmination of our shared journey, highlighting the power of love in fostering healthier, more caring work environments to deliver on a shared purpose and deliver results to all stakeholders. On behalf of Spread Love In Organizations team, we express our deepest gratitude for your unwavering support, genuine feedback, and above all, the love that has flooded every aspect of this incredible endeavor. Our devoted community has played an integral role in shaping this podcast into what it is today. So, without further ado, let us embark on this special episode, united by the common purpose of cultivating empathy, genuine care, and love within organizations for people to feel safe to thrive, be at their best, and imagine a better world. Thank you for joining us on this extraordinary journey.
And somebody shared a story from Steve Jobs from 1983 when he had an offsite, and it was the time that they were designing the Mac. And he said that he would much rather be a pirate than part of the Navy. And what he meant by it is, and the second phrase that he talked about, he said, was because pirates are audacious and courageous. And he wanted the team at Apple at the time to push the edge of innovation and really challenge themselves to do things differently to everybody else. You know, and I think that's true for the culture that I personally believe in. You know, and a lot of the places I've worked and the way we've done things on the teams that I've been responsible for weren't the norm. You know, they weren't what, you know, when you said, you know, you care more about other people than your own career. Or, you know, let people go, let them trust that they're going to do good work. Don't feel like, you know, going back to this idea of autonomy, don't feel like you have to, you know, review every slide they're producing. Will it be perfect? No, but it'll be their own work and they'll be pretty proud of it. I think that fits into this courage piece around culture, which is don't, you know, if you believe that's the culture you need to be successful, maybe it doesn't quite mix that meet the corporate culture that's preached or delivered, that's, you know, that's okay. Do what you think is right by people. And I think that phrase of kindness being free is a good reminder as well when it comes to that too.
And then spreading the love is about recognizing each other. And I think one of the things that that I noticed as I came in is that we probably weren't doing enough of that and as consistently as we should. So it's an open forum where people have the opportunity to voluntarily kind of in the moment sort of say, I want to recognize so-and-so because they helped with this. They can send something in advance of the meeting. Sometimes they do, and we get some fun stories that we can share more intentionally in the lead up to the meeting. So there's a lot of love, I guess, that's shared in moments like that. And again, very specific, you know, examples of how you recognize someone you want to, you know, spread the love to, so to speak. And that forum, I think, has made a nice kind of neat kind of way of doing the developmental stuff, the important business stuff, along with recognizing our teammates, and not just folks in marketing, but in different functions as well.
So I think spread love, well, one word, it's so right. it's you know, I was thinking a little bit about our conversation, and it was funny the other day, Naji, I'm an Economist reader. At the bottom of the espresso version of The Economist, there's always a quote. And a couple of weeks back, there was a quote from a French guy, Emile Chartier, a French philosopher and pacifist. And the I'm going to get the quote wrong, but let me try this. It's something along, politeness is for people to whom we feel indifferent, and moods, both good and bad, are for those we love. So when you talk about spreading love, which can sound a little bit soft, when I say it's so right, it's about us genuinely connecting and caring for others, for all the good things, for all the bad things, and being our real selves and helping them be their real selves. It's not just about, you know, a universal hug and being nice. It's about caring, and caring enough. And again, people smell the bullshit when it's not real. It's about really caring enough that you can help people be their authentic selves, and then they'll fly and they'll succeed and engage. And of course, you know, all the leadership books will talk about purpose and process and resource and all the other elements that we know are so important. But spread love, if we interpret that as really deeply caring for others and for each other and for ourselves, you know, the business isn't going to go too far wrong.
Well, it is just that, though. Spread love. I don't know if I need to translate that more. I think it's about linking arms. It's about really getting to know each other as humans. I think it starts there. It doesn't start anywhere more complicated than just that. I think we talked about this yesterday. I talked about this with another physician and a nurse leader. We talked about just trying to get the doctor and the nurses together to eat cookies together. You know, that's how you need to build human connections. That's spreading love. You know, how finding out what your dog's name or your cat's name and how many kids you have, that's spreading love, and it starts there. I think if we could do the pandemic, unfortunately, push some of that boundaries, you know, physically away from us. But spreading love is rather simple. It's about really building that human connection one at a time, maybe over a cookie.
The way that I think about spreading to, and this is your quote, spreading love through the organization is caring, truly caring for people and demonstrating that in a number of different ways. There are a number of maybe axioms or truths that one has to abide by. One of them is to really be completely truthful to people, and not just for people to hear what they want to hear, but truly what they should be hearing. And I know that sometimes people say, well, that's hard love. It is really not hard love. It is just truly caring about the person. So when it comes to spreading love or care, I think it starts with the intent, having the right intent, and having a transparent, honest relationship with your colleagues. I think that's the basis for that.
Love, Buckminster Fuller said, is metaphysical gravity, right? So gravity is a physical force that makes two objects of mass attracted to each other, that they, you know, fortunately I'm very stuck on this earth right now because of gravity. It's a wonderful thing. Instead of floating off, here I am. And love is metaphysical gravity. Love is that the very real but often under-acknowledged connections that we all have with each other.
It's funny, in the business world, people don't really use the word love very much, but they'll express their commitment or their happiness or their loathing for certain things in industry. And the fact of the matter is, I think it all comes down to essentially love, because if you love what you do, you're more passionate about it. If you treat the people around you with love and compassion and respect, they do the same. If you treat them with disrespect and all of the opposite things, well, they're going to treat you the same, or they're going to go someplace else. When you take a look at most studies around why great companies succeed or why great teams are built, there's volumes of philosophy, but one recurring theme is people feel valued. People will leave a very high paying job because they just feel nobody gives a shit. I am not valued. I'm doing my thing. And yes, they pay me well, but I've lost the fire that whether it be emotional or intellectual stimulation. And when you think about that, like, that comes down to love. It comes down to, do people here really respect what each other do, no matter what the role is? I don't care whether it's, you know, the guy or girl that are flipping grilled cheese sandwiches in the company cafeteria with a smile on their face every day, the VP of sales that's, you know, struggling to hit his budget. If people feel valued, they feel loved. And if they feel loved, they're going to be committed. And if they're committed, the organization has a higher probability of success just based on the sheer will of that individual as a group.
Brilliance. The first thing I think of is absolutely, and not just in organizations, but in our communities everywhere. I'm so thrilled that you've taken this project on and are, you know, I feel like we're on the same wagon here, both of us doing the same effort, trying to, just like you said, spread love in organizations, spread love, spread care. Ultimately, when we bring that into organizations, it spreads to the patients we serve. Start with our people, and then that will result. I'm all about productivity, right? And I love the ripple effect of when we can spread love in our organizations, that means they're going to do better work. And that means we're going to serve more patients and spread more love and more health around the world.
It has to do with care, right, Nadia? It's really going to the message, you know, like people won't care how much you know until they know how much you care, right? And in any organization, people are going to make a big difference if they know you care, you know, like... I had this interesting story. It reflects, I think, like my, like a goal in life. So I was in a restaurant the other day with friends, some colleagues from MIT, and then we were talking, you know, like just kind of that philosophical discussion, say, you know, what do you expect for life and what you're gonna have, like when you retire or something. And I told this to them. It came out of me. I never actually said it the way I said, but I told them. I said, well, I think there are two things I expect in my life. One is, When I retire as a professor, who is going to be my retirement party? I mean, like, who is going to be there, right? It has to be the people. It is the people, the students and the colleague that will make a difference. It is about spreading love to the people around you and caring about them, right? So I told them, I said, you know, what's our legacy in life? It's going to be the people. And it has to do about, you know, the people that make a difference, the people that you touch, and what is that if not spreading love and caring for each other? So this is what I said about my retirement party. But the interesting thing that I told them, which I had never said, is that I said, in when I die, in my funeral, I just hope that a friend is going to stand up and say, you know, I miss this guy. That was a good friend. And if I can, you know, like say, I think that's a goal in life, is to be a good friend, you know, just to understand that people around us, they can look at you and say, this guy has my back, you know, and I think spreading love is that. It's caring for each other and have each other's back.
Okay, so we're going to be very honest here. When I first saw the spread love in organizations, something didn't sit well with me. I said, like, oh, Naji, what's wrong with you? Like, why love? Like, no one's going to take you seriously. I still struggle with the word love. I think it's very, very bold. But I have to give you the like, kudos to you, because it has the merit of thought-provoking. I am much more comfortable with the word, like, care, spread care in the organization. But put this aside. The concept is phenomenal, like seriously. It's not only, I would say, moral imperative. I do believe, like, morally, we have to care and love each other. But I do believe in it's business imperative. Because if I care, I take care of my team, they will take care of their customers, and then we will all benefit. But at the same time, I feel in my own experience, if people know that you care, they allow themselves, like, the masks are down, and they allow themselves to be, like, completely, to bring their true self to work. I was reading 2 days ago about an experimentation that took place in some university. To be honest, I don't know which university, so apologies for that, where a professor asked his students to inflate balloons and put their name into the balloons. Very, very simple task. And then he took all the balloons and then put them in the hallway, mixed the balloons, and asked the students, like, you have 5 minutes, find your own balloon, the balloon with your own name. Of course, after hectic search, no one was able to find within 5 minutes their own balloon. And then he said, okay, let's change tactic. Now pick a balloon and give it to the person whose name is in it. Of course, like, within less than 2 minutes, everyone had their own balloon. And I do believe that success in organization is very much like balloons. If we are all looking for ours, we will never find it. But if you really care and love others, you will find yours as well.
Well, spread love. I think the first thing that comes to my mind is kind of what's a word that you know we could also use, right? If maybe some people say or at first have a reaction to love, that maybe that's not the place in business. And I would say, just to move into this direction, a first half step into it is spread appreciation. So that's often, right, if you work in traditional business environments, appreciation is a currency that is highly undervalued. And without appreciation, particularly, you know, most of us now coming out of COVID, maybe sometimes we don't know, everyone in every single family, you have mental health issues, right? Particularly if you have younger people in your family. But regardless of the generation, really, kind of the mental health, the stress, the anxiety disorder, the depression. And I think one of the main, I wouldn't use the word healing, but one of the main forces, right, to really deal with these issues is appreciation, right? It's appreciation of each other, is of our situation, kind of what's still working for us, and kind of so this is I think kind of the capacity to appreciate is very central, really, for all human health, I would say. And then, you know, love in organizations, I do believe it is at you know, pretty much at the source of everything. And I remember a very well-known famous action researcher here in Cambridge. So he was a Harvard professor, and he's one of the great innovators of organizational learning in the later part of the last century, Chris Argyris. And he once said that the only way to do good work as a consultant is to love your client, right? And I think that's totally true, right? So if you now, so that's what he says as a consultant, right? But I would say the only way to do your best work as a leader is to love the people and the larger ecosystem you're in service of as the leader, right? So because what does love mean, right? What love really means in this context is the capacity to see someone else in their highest future possibility and to support them in getting there. That's what love is. And that's what leadership is. So from that regard, there's not much of a difference. And that's why with your intuition and with your podcast, you're right on the money.
It's really important that we do that. And one of the things is love, kindness, all these things, all these aspects that people treat as like soft things, you know, they don't, it's not, you know, ROIs or hard deliverables. They're not mutually exclusive of profit. They're not mutually exclusive of innovation, like love, kindness, they're all, they can actually help us achieve profit. So I think in a corporation where we're used to having to explain to board members or our leadership certain initiatives that we want to take and where we have to show the ROI of that, we can, you know, have initiatives that are spreading kindness and love, really show not only the positive impact of that, but also an actual ROI in terms of profitability, in terms of savings, in terms of, the advancement of a company. So both of those things can be, they're not mutually exclusive, and both of them can be actually help each other.
Yeah, it can be an ROI amplifier, actually, yeah. as you
said. I love that word. Yeah, exactly.
So, you know, I love that. And this is why I'm a big fan of what you do, Naji. Earlier, I said there's three main characteristics of a leader. And I think that the last one resonates with this word that I'll tell you is empathy. A little bit of empathy goes a long way. There's a really great book that I read recently by Mo Gaudat, which is Solve for Happy. And there's a lot of great nuggets of wisdom in that one. One that really I liked was how the author frames how we perceive the world and says we are all movie stars in our own movies, and everybody we interact with is a supporting actor. So right now I'm the movie star of my movie and you're the supporting actor, and in your world it's vice versa. And a little bit of empathy will help us oversee, not oversee the fact that separate reality exists, and will allow us just enough to keep our eyes and our ears open to understanding where other people are coming from. So spreading love in organizations has to come from empathy, has to come from that ability to recognize that, sure, you are the movie star of your own movie, but you have to understand sometimes that the person sitting in front of you feels exactly the same. And maybe you should play a supporting role for that love to spread. Because if everybody stays as the movie star, the team will fall apart.
I think we're at an inflection point. And there's a generational dimension to this as well. And it's a good thing. People in the generations that are coming up leading now have so much awareness about the psychological dimensions of life, of leadership, of what they can expect from work, and really have no desire to tolerate a psychologically unsafe environment that doesn't care for people. In my father's day, or in other generations, they would get a job and stay there for 40 years, even if they didn't like it, because that was the way it worked. The world doesn't work, and we have brain drain. So when I think of spread love, I also think of retaining talent, of cultivating talent, of making people feel valued so they can help build an organization and feel that they are part of it, which doesn't mean that the older generations don't have a lot to offer. It just means we can't expect to treat people the way we did, let's say, in the 1950s, Mad Men, to reference a popular culture reference of a TV show about, you know, the way we used to conduct the top-down command-control type of leadership that was insensitive and biased and so forth. So spread love to me is about literally moving organizations into the future so that the new generation of leaders feel we have a home for them here and that they don't feel that somehow they have to conform to a way of treating people that leaves caring about your personal life at the door, or says check your values are at the door, or you have to leave aside purpose and quality of life. You know, I can quote studies where we see this is what people care about. They don't just want to go to work and be a cog in a machine. So that's what I think about when I think of spread love.
I think the key thing is the right kind of love. See, and what I mean by the right kind of love is that, you see, all of our understanding of love is very transactional these days. We might have good framing around it, but at the end of the day, it becomes transactional. And by transactional, I mean that we don't suspend our expectations around, you know, what it is that we're expecting from somebody else. And sometimes these expectations take over our ability to love. You see, we start calculating, So first key thing is everybody's worthy of love without judgment. So, the second thing around it is that try to make it less transactional, and which means at times suspending our expectations, which means at times, also sort of, acting on values such as kindness and compassion and forgiveness, that those are all aspects of the wholesome understanding of love.
So, Naji, you and I talked a little bit about this. I think that the concept of love inside of organizations has such a new pervasive element because of this important work on belonging, I think. But also because I think it is now one very positive silver lining coming out of, I think, the last couple of years is that it is a part of the vernacular. I think the challenge is, how do we move love to action? And I think that there's now a lot that is in the vernacular about love in the context, maybe not love, but kindness and compassion and making, you know, organizations feel more like a place where, you know, a safe space where people can come. But I think the challenge of now moving to action, what do we see in the actions that we hold and that we challenge ourselves to do? That to me is, I think, the important next step.
Well, I think that, look, the way that you spread love in organization, it starts with kindness, as we've talked about, right? It talks about, as a leader, what's the culture you're creating? And that, to me, as a leader, probably the most important role that you have, and in particular, you know, in a large organization, is, you know, you can't impact, I mean, to some extent, as a member of our executive committee, I was leading an organization of 140,000 people, you know, 2,000 directly, but company of 140,000. So you can't touch that many people individually. You can't touch 2,000 people individually. What you can do as a leader is create a culture where you can really demand kindness. I wouldn't say just encourage, but ensure there's kindness, ensure there's ethical leadership, that people are making value-driven decisions, treating people in an ethical way, looking out for patients and consumers in a values-based manner. And so I think that by creating that culture, That's how you spread love in an organization.
I love this concept, you know, because, you know, I want to reflect on something that I learned during COVID. And for me, it was I took for granted the time I spent with people, for instance, in the pantry, over a coffee and so on. And suddenly COVID came and we were all behind the screen, where even if you want to show genuine care, it's quite difficult. Yeah, it's for me, it was a quite difficult thing to show on a screen. Sometimes I felt people are asking questions about others, other peers, like if they care, why it was like not really true. So I felt that what we took for granted when it comes to having genuine care about each other in an organization, and is nothing we should take for granted, because it matters. Especially, as I said, with COVID, turning completely virtual was quite difficult for everyone. So people felt also isolated. And for me, this is a quite important point that I realized. And taking care of others is very, very, very crucial, because we felt the difference during COVID, how much we did effort to show the care while it was so easily shown when you are in a face-to-face interaction or with real interaction. So it is very important that we continue to have to spread this genuine care, and that should be consistently there and regularly there. Because, you know, when you care about people, at the end of the day, for me, when you care about people, when you encourage them, when you listen to the even small, sometimes not very big things from your side, but someone is sharing with you, you feel this emotional connection between you and any other employee. And this has a tremendous impact, because it creates a sense of community, if you want, a sense of belonging and happiness. So that will strengthen all the engagement people have toward any company. And overall, it affects the culture, the organizational culture. And you cannot expect bad results from that. On the contrary, you would expect great results when you have this engagement and the culture.
Spreading love in organizations, the way that I understand that, is that there are two levels of doing that. There is first the superficial level that most people get stuck on, which is to be nice, to say please and say thank you, and, you know, you're standing in line in the cafeteria and you pay for the person behind you and all of that. Now, all of that is good. You know, I'm not against any of that. But I think the real love being spread in organizations is done by being generous with others, by mentoring the young comers, by taking time from your busy schedule to sit down with someone and help them work through a problem, or listen to their personal situation and being empathetic and being compassionate with them. So the first level of spreading love, you know, we can call that confetti kindness. We can call that superficial kindness, because it really doesn't take a lot of time and energy, and it's very convenient, right? But the real work of spreading love, in my opinion, is the type that takes time, takes energy, takes commitment, and is sometimes inconvenient, but you still do it because it's the right thing to do. And as we just explained in terms of the research, it's the only way to do it going forward with the challenges that every organization is facing right now. I truly believe that no organization is going to be able to survive this, you know, COVID pandemic that we're going through and burnout and all of that without love being one of its values.
Yeah, I am so lucky every day to go to work. And because we talk about patients' life and death every day, it's so easy for us to be so personal with each other. It's so easy for our organization to get around our mission. I don't have to create a mission and a value statement, and it doesn't take long for people to understand what it means to have a loved one living longer, or for me to know that as an employee, you're working really hard and we care about the patient. But one thing I will tell you I've learned in this role in the last 3 years, Naji, is sometimes we're so focused on saving patients' lives that we forget to focus on the employees that are actually doing it and showing them that we care about them as much as we care about the patient. The pandemic really put our organization, as it did many, in overdrive. You would think that working from home meant that we were working less hours when everybody was working so many more hours. There was a blur between work and personal, and really burnout occurring. And I think we've seen that in the great resignation that's happening and that we're going through now in the world of people really taking a second look at, am I actually spending the time with my family, my loved ones, not just helping those patients live longer, helping patients and their families, but what about my family? And so for me, spreading love at Kite is a greater focus on loving our employees and showing them recognition, showing them appreciation, developing them not just through promotions, but developing them not just at work, but in their personal, what do they want to develop personally, socially, that we can help them with. So for me, that's the next thing to double down on, is love for our employees.
This has never become more important to me. I think you and I have had conversations about this since I met you, but it's become even more important to me because I think in a post-COVID world, then in a world where all of a sudden there are all these conversations around diversity and equity and inclusion, and we see a world where there's a lot of polarization and a lot of ugliness and a lot of othering and words that have a lot of hate and unkindness in them, I think organizations, all organizations, need a lot more love, and in that love needs a lot more patience and understanding and compassion and empathy and real true kindness, right? Kindness in the sense that really give people the benefit of the doubt and assume the best in people. And that's not to say that people are necessarily coming with the best of intentions, but I feel like when you create a space where, or a work culture where that assumption is there, you're lifting up the bar and you're asking people to show up as the best versions of themselves. And I don't think we do that enough in organizations. So I think we absolutely need to see, I think now more than ever, just more love and kindness in how we show up for each other in a workplace.
The idea of spreading love in an organization was uncomfortable for me. And probably till very late in my career, if you'd said, how do you spread love? I would have been like, well, that's not what we do here, Naji. This is work and it's, you know, supposed to be tough. And it's, but you know, so much of what we've been talking about is about caring deeply for other people and people who are different from you and trying to help them be better and some self-sacrifice. And I think spread love in an organization is not about the intimacy and the feelings that you have for a spouse or a family member, but it is about deep caring for other people and wanting to see them succeed and rallying behind them when they have a difficult circumstance, whether it's in their in their business life or in their personal life, and caring enough about them to be there for them. And you know, people will run toward a leader that is there for them when they need them the most and when they didn't expect it, and run from a leader who's not there for them under difficult circumstances. The challenge for organizations and a healthcare company is how do you as an organization demonstrate to people that that you care for them and you love them in that sense. And you know, organizations don't love people, but I think the recipe there is you've got to hire leaders at every level, and especially at the most senior level, who lead by example in that way and really put their people first and are willing to exemplify that in the most difficult circumstances. And there's probably precious few companies that most of their people feel like that's what their leaders look like and how they operate.
So when I heard about this, I think there would be a late professor, her name is Sigal Barsaid, who would be absolutely thrilled to hear that you're doing this this podcast. She passed away last year. She was fantastic. She's at Wharton. She has a paper on companion love in organizations. So one of the big ideas that she's left in the field is sort of this idea that we need to have more love at work. And love, not romantic love, companion love, this idea of affection and caring for others, and showing that that leads to really positive downstream outcomes at work.
I am fascinated by what the preamble that you gave. I think it's a very interesting way to present in our industry, which is a technical industry, correct? So the way you have decided to spread love, and you're making your point that we learn from each other, that human beings learn from each other, and we grow and grow together, which is, you know, is my philosophy about mentorship, right? That's why I'm so grateful to my mentors. I've been lucky to have that many, obviously my parents and my friends and new friends, such as you, Naji, you know, they're all become my mentors. Because so I feel like the way you your thesis of spread love, I loved it. Thank you for including me.
Spread love is not more than servant leadership, genuine care, fearless organizations, you know, from Amy Edmondson, and so many great, great researchers, thought leaders who talked about this, right? It's just this. I think the word love makes it a little bit different. You know, people would stop when they hear an executive saying, you know, I want to spread love. It's exactly this, how you care about your people and you make sure that there's a culture where they can be themselves and they can thrive towards the common and shared purpose that the organization have.
Hope you enjoyed this special episode. See you next week with our 101 new episode.
Love.